Cisco SD-WAN bandwidth policy makes it possible to limit bandwidth of a specific data traffic. It is a data plane policy which can be implemented both in localized and centralized policy. Although bandwidth policing is a data plane policy, but it can be implemented both through localized and also centralized policy. We can push the policy directly to WAN edge routers through a localized policy, or it can be implemented via a centralized policy. If a data plane policy, such as bandwidth policy, is implemented through a centralized policy, the final policy must be pushed from vSmart controller to WAN edge routers. Otherwise, it cannot affect data traffic since data traffic never goes through vSmart controller. This is the topology in which we implement bandwidth policy. Site 1 to site 4 are connected to each other through existing SD-WAN infrastructure. All WAN edge routers are connected to the LAN site through Gigabit Ethernet 3 interface and with the IP subnet from 172.16.11.12.13.14. As an example, I have connected two computers behind site 1 and site 4 with IP addresses 172.16.11.10 and 172.16.14.10. Our target is to limit upload bandwidth from site 1 to site 4 to a specific value. We will implement this scenario with both localized and centralized policy. With the localized policy, we apply the policy directly to Gigabit Ethernet 3 of WAN edge router in site 1 in the direction from LAN to WAN. In the topology, it is shown with green color. With centralized policy, policy will be applied to vSmart controller, but finally it will be pushed from vSmart controller to Gigabit Ethernet 3 of site 1 WAN edge router, so it can control data traffic bandwidth from site 1 to site 4. Another important point to note is that delay, jitter, and loss are not the only quality of service parameters which can control the quality of applications. But bandwidth is probably the most important quality of service parameter. Because if the bandwidth is sufficient for an application, we have no delay, jitter, or losses in our data traffic. In QoS, we have two options for bandwidth control. Bandwidth limiting that can be implemented using bandwidth policing or bandwidth shaping. Another option is to guarantee bandwidth of a given application, which can be implemented using queuing tools. Before we start configuring bandwidth policing, let's check how much bandwidth we have from site 1 to site 4 if there is no restriction in bandwidth. We check it with sending FTP traffic from site 1 to site 4. I upload file and then we can check the bandwidth. The upload speed is 1 megabit per second without any restriction. In the first step, we configure final allowed and restricted bandwidth, which we will limit from site 1 to site 4. Let's configure it, for example, to 200 kilobit per second. Policies, localized policy, custom option, list, and policer, new policer list, and policer list name, 200 kilobit per second, and 200,000 bit per second. 200,000, and the exit action, job. Policy itself will be implemented through access controls in the localized policy, add access control list, add IPv4 access list policy with the name of site 1 underline site 4 underline ACL, add access sequence, sequence rule from source destination 172.16.11 from site 1 to site 4. The action must be accept and then policer und counter. Policer 200 kilobit per second and counter name site 1 to site 4 underline count and then add default action must be permit, must be changed to permit not to drop any traffic and then save. Now we need to apply our access control policy to CH1 routers. There is already a localized data plane policy that is applied to CH1 router in previous sections, name CH1 underline policy. We will edit this policy to add our new access control list policy. Access control list, add import existing site 1 to site 4 access list. Now we can preview our final command that will be copied to CH1 router, site 1 to site 4 accesses for the traffic with the source and destination 172.16.11 to 14. The action must be policer 200 kilobit per second with the counter and default action is accept. And this is our policer. And save policy. Configure device. The configuration must be copied to CH1 router. But still, it is not finished. Now we have to apply our access control list policy to Gigabit Ethernet 3 interface in CH1 router and with a direction from LAN to WAN. So in the template, feature template, Gigabit Ethernet 3 interface, which is CSR1000V interface connected to data center. Edit. In the section access list quality of service. And then ingress access list global on. And the name of the access list. Update let's check the configuration changes. The new configuration is to apply access list to Gigabit Ethernet 3 of CH1 router and then configure device. Again, we check our bandwidth from site 1 to site 4 with sending FTP traffic. We expect that the bandwidth will be limited to 200 kilobit per second. Let's stop. Remove. And again, upload. At the same time, we can check our bandwidth policy and if it affects traffic through CLI, comma. It must be limited to 200 kilobit per second. I will check it again. With command show SD-WAN policy access list association, we check which policies apply to which interface with gigabit Ethernet trees, the access is site 1 to site 4 access list. We command show SD-WAN policy access list counter. We check if traffic are matched with our policy. The connection is limited to 200 kilobit per second, and you can see here that about 5,000 packets are matched with this access list. And with command show SD-WAN policy access list policer, we can check the policy itself and how much traffic is matched with the policy. The policy itself is 200 kilobit per second, and it is the packet which is matched with the access list itself. As the second method, we will implement the same scenario, but this time through centralized policy. First, we have to remove our current localized policy so we can make sure that the traffic is matched with our new centralized policy. So in the template, feature template, in the interface gigabit Ethernet tree, which is connected to data center, edit, in the section accesses QoS, and then default and update. The configuration must be removed from gigabit Ethernet tree. Let's check it. As you can see, the access list is removed from gigabit Ethernet tree, and then configure device. Now we can create our new centralized policy to limit bandwidth from site 1 to site 4. Policy, centralized policy, traffic policy, traffic data, add policy, create new. If you remember, we have many options in the centralized policy and in the section traffic policy, some of which we implemented in previous sections, such as access list and application firewall, traffic engineering. In this section, we choose quality of service as our policy type to configure bandwidth policy. With the name site 1, underline 2, underline site 4, underline policy, and sequence rule, source data prefix, destination data prefix from 172.16.11 to 172.16.14, and the action policer and counter with policer 200 kilobit per second and counter site 1 underline 2 underline site 4 underline count, and the save. Default action must be changed to accept so no traffic is dropped, and then save data policy. Then we need to tell VS Smart Controller which sites the policy needs to be copied and in which direction. So centralized policy, we have already VS Smart policy applied to VS Smart Controller, edit, in the traffic data import site 1 to site 4 policing. Then we have to apply policy application traffic data site 1 to site 4 policing from service to WAN infrastructure, apply to hub and VPN 10 add. Before activating new policy, we preview the command. Site 1 to site 4 policing with the source IP and destination IP 172.16.11.14. The action is policer, and this is also the cont, and default action is also accept. Now we can save and activate the policy. Let's check again effective bandwidth from site 1 to site 4 with sending FTP traffic from site 1 to site 4. Stop, remove, and again upload. The bandwidth must be limited to 200 kilobit per second. At the same time, we check it with CLI command to make sure that the policies pushed to CH1 router and traffic are matched with our policy. With command show SD-WAN policy from VSmart data policy, we check if policies push from VSmart controller to CH1 router. As you can see, the policy is pushed to CH1 router. Now with command show SD-WAN policy data policy filter, we make sure if traffic are matched with our policy. As you can see, this is site 1 to site 4 count data policy, and these are the packets, the number of the packet match with our policy, and the bandwidth is limited about to 200 kilobit per second as we expect.